Here, in the shadow of the San Buenaventura Mission, many ghosts have been reported. We're going to examine those tales, and we have with us EVP, a local Ventura group, looking into the stories of hauntings. They'll come and see if they can confirm some of the many accounts of ghosts at Mission Plaza with the ghost hunters of Ventura County. Many places in downtown Ventura are haunted. This old place behind me is perhaps one of the most haunted in all of my files. The old Santa Clara House, now a popular restaurant, has a ghostly woman who haunts the bathroom. In fact, if you look up behind me, the window to the bathroom is right there, and people have seen the phantom figure looking out the window. Now, people have seen her, and the story is she was named Rosa, an Italian woman who actually fell in love with an Italian salesman who had visited Ventura. He promised to take her away and show her the sights of the world, but he didn't come back. And so, pregnant now, unable to hide her difficult pregnancy, she took her own life by hanging herself in her room. That room has now been changed into the ladies' bathroom. And as such, it's haunted. People feel an icy cold there. They see a woman in a green dress. Sometimes she wanders down the stairs. She's been seen in all different locations of the old restaurant, this Victorian home. Now, people also claim that there are two other ghosts haunting that place. Though the woman, Rosa, is perhaps the most known, others have seen a man and a small child haunting the structure. The people who have the restaurant now, they don't know what to believe of the stories, but it seems as if Rosa does, in fact, still haunt the bathroom. If you doubt it, go there yourself and see if you encounter the strange phantom of Rosa at the old Santa Clara House. The old firehouse in Ventura has been turned into a new use. It's now the Clock Tower Inn Hotel. People have had ghostly experiences here as well. But oddly enough, the ghosts aren't firemen at all. They're in fact one room, number 210. People have seen a ghostly woman. She seems to be linked to the old mission because she wears the type of dress that the native converts wore here at the mission. All she is seen is standing there. Sometimes she comes and looks at people right in the eye. In fact, one woman woke up and saw the ghost woman 6 inches from her nose. The ghost turned away and vanished into nothing. We have honored the firefighters of Ventura with a small museum dedicated to those early firefighters who gave their all to help defend the city. And some of their equipment, some of their faces can be viewed in the small vest pocket museum. Who is the ghost? Why is she here? Again, we don't know. But there was a large Chinese community here. Some 200 members called this place home. They had their own fire department, their own temple, their own stores and businesses. And it seems one of those Chinese has lingered on, has been seen as a ghost time and time again. Who he is and why he's still here, no one knows. We have a ghost hunting team with us from EVP, that's East Ventura Paranormal. They've agreed to come out and see if they can find evidence of some of the many ghosts in Mission Park. Our first site is a place where a Chinese specter has been seen repeatedly. So let's go there and see if we can find out who this Asian phantom happens to be and why they're there, if possible. China Alley. This is where the Chinese community was long ago, before the construction of other buildings. And people in this very site have seen a Chinese gentleman. He's been seen for at least the last 30 years. He's wearing some sort of robe, and he has a small pillbox hat. People, at least four people I know of, have seen and encountered this phantom. Most recently, he's seen just as a ball of light. We're going to let the EVP group come and see if they can find anything out of the ordinary at this location. What are you going to be doing to investigate the site?
Well, we're going to look for things that are unusual. We'll look for electromagnetic fields. We'll look for cold spots. We have cameras. We have infrared cameras. Hopefully, we'll pick something up that way. We have digital voice recorders, and hopefully, we'll pick up some sort of electronic voice phenomenon, which EVP stands for electronic voice phenomenon. That's why we named our group EVPs. So we just use different assortment of equipment.
Okay, well, have at it.
Okay, come on in, guys. Let's do it. And also, we have a psychic with us. Maybe Maria can get some kind of reading. You never know. Okay. You notice that everybody is bringing out cameras and digital voice recorders. Hopefully, in a real controlled environment, we'd probably be asking questions of the spirit. If we can make some sort of contact with the spirit, we'd be asking specific questions like name, how long they've been deceased, do they know where they're at now? It's kind of confining when we can't actually get back in the area that they're looking into. But we're restricted, so the best we can do is hope. The infrared cameras and the digital cameras, to me, are very important. They pick up a lot of stuff that you can't necessarily see with your eyes. Same with the digital voice recorders. If you physically hear something, we call that a disembodied voice. And of course, our recorders and cameras will pick that up as well. But a lot of times things go unnoticed to the human ear, and that's where the digital voice recorder comes in. They pick up sounds, they pick up voices, they pick up all sorts of different communications that we don't necessarily hear.
Many different Chinese businesses here, laundries, businesses. They had their own temple at one time. This was a fully enclosed community where everything they needed was all in one small spot. Most of the Chinese worked as farm laborers here in the area. They were the first migrant farm workers. And unfortunately, they were treated very poorly by the community, who saw them as subhuman in many ways. And they faced unrelenting prejudice.
Was there a strong opium influence?
There was opium. There were several opium dens, but up until 1914, it wasn't even illegal. So, in fact, when they did raid the opium den, which was right across the street, most of the people inside were Yankees, not Chinese.
Is that right?
They also had a Chinese brothel, several different places where the Chinese could enjoy themselves, the gambling dens, things of that nature. They did have a church as well, a Presbyterian.
So they were entrepreneurs just like everybody else.
Very true. Chinese have always been entrepreneurs. They still are.
Correct.
And they were well represented. Remarkably, 1927, the city forced them all to move. They said that they were bringing plague or they were unclean. So you know what they did? They moved to Oxnard. They just took all their stuff and went over there and reestablished themselves. They even had their own Chinese fire department. And that became, they took their equipment with them, that became the nucleus of the Oxnard Fire Department. They actually had the same cart. And it had these Chinese characters painted on the front of it. It was a hand-pulled cart with a hose on it. And they didn't know what the little symbols mean, so they hired someone from China to translate it. And they thought it was poetry or something like that. It isn't. It says, hold here, don't put hand here. It was just safety instructions.
Yeah.
Okay, could you introduce the psychic? I'd like to see what she feels.
Maria, would you join us for a minute, please?
Sure.
Are you sensing any psychic impressions tonight?
There is what feels like just layers of things, you know? Mostly what I would call, residual, you know? Nothing is stepping forward to me yet, but, you know, night's young, you never know. And it's like with anything, it's not a sure thing, so.
Maria's really pretty talented, very gifted. We were on an investigation with Richard's wife, Debbie, was there as well, who's also a psychic. And she gave a very specific reading from that site. Maria in another room gave me a separate reading, and when we compared them, they were almost identical. I mean,
really down
everything close. Was so close, it was scary.
Well, there's one account that the Chinese ghost is here because he was illegally buried here.
Hmm.
Perhaps a murder victim. You're not getting that?
What I get is just emotions. You know, and it's kind of a multitude of emotions, you know, from time passage. You know, I mean, I'd have to really sit and really kind of get into my groove, whatever you call it. But, I mean, I'll do that. You know, just I haven't had a chance to really acclimate into it yet, so.
We're going to examine stories of the old Mission San Buenaventura and let them continue their investigation here before we tackle another site. Gene, have you guys come up with anything?
I tell you, Richard, it's been very active. You guys walked away to go to that section over there, and my K2 meter started going nuts. K2 will pick up electromagnetic fields, and when it's just on in green like this, it's your base reading. And the more lights light up, the more electromagnetic activity is going on. And this thing was pegged. It was all, everything was lit up all the way over into the red bulbs. And then Maria started...
Come forward,
started
Maria.
Doing her thing.
What happened? Did you manage to pick up something?
There is a young boy. I get the impression of some phrases and words like, Yomi Shui, which for some reason I think is Mandarin. I have no idea because I don't speak any of that language.
I wish we had a Mandarin speaker with us.
But Yomi Shui, and I think he's thirsty. And I don't get any ambivalence from him. I don't get any where he's angry or anything. He's just kind of like acquiesced into a situation. He's young. He's probably late teens. Then... I get the name of, was there a laundry thing around here?
Oh, there were five laundries in this area.
What was the name I was saying?
No. Something like that.
Ho. See, I've lost it because it's like going through my head so
fast.
Well,
I do know that direct close by was the Wing Hai Laundry. And, there was Sing Ki's restaurant, Chinese restaurant, right across the street from us.
It has to do with his uncle who brought him over here. Wo Hing. That was
Wo
it.
Hing.
Wo Hing.
There was a Hing. I know that.
Yeah, I get the name Wo Hing. I get a relationship as an uncle.
Wo was the first name.
Yeah,
Hing is
Wo
the
Hing.
Last name.
So.
Well, actually, they're reversed.
Well, I mean, this is what I'm getting, and that's who brought him over here.
They usually had a sponsor of some type. Did you get any other readings, of divergent readings?
No, just a lot of, like, miscellaneous energies and stuff.
Well, there was a lot of activity.
Yeah,
here.
But he kind of hit me for a loop once I kind of channeled into him and stuff, but... He's not angry, not sad, not scared. He's just kind of acquiesced to a situation where he's just kind of watches.
Do you think if we conducted a Buddhist burial service that that might help lay the ghost?
It might, but I think he's just kind of like just hanging out. You know, he's not, I don't know. It's not like he's afraid to reincarnate like the Buddhists, you know, mm-hmm. believe and stuff like that. He's just kind of acquiesced to a situation because I think he believed that he was the reason for his situation.
Ah, he may have somehow caused it.
Right.
That reincarnating might have him reincarnate in a lesser form.
Maybe. I don't know. I mean, I'm not a Buddhist, so I don't know. But though I do believe in reincarnation, I think he's just watching and waiting. I don't know if he's waiting for some kind of deliverance or whatever, but I think he really thinks he's part of the cause of what his situation is right now, or what brought his situation about.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. We have someone dowsing or using a pendulum. Using a pendulum, trying to establish communication. Yeah. What are you getting?
I was asking questions in my head, and after I asked the first question, it started to pick up speed and spin in a circle, which, as you can see, I'm holding it right now, it's not doing. And I would say, okay, I'm going to ask the next question. Can you stop the pendulum? And it would just stop. And I'd ask another question, and this is the first time I've ever used a pendulum.
Look at the meter. It's really blasting away. We are getting some kind of a reaction on the K2 meteor.
One of the questions I asked, since Maria said that he was young, I asked if he was about my age.
And what does it say?
And it started to spin.
That would be a yes.
Yeah.
So you too are confirming what she's catching.
See?
There it goes. Look at it now. It's really going.
So is the K2.
Yeah. Ask, are you Chinese?
Are you Chinese? Can you stop the pendulum?
It's stopping. All right. Ask him, are you happy?
Are you happy here?
It's going back and forth. Which means maybe no.
Are you content?
Oh, no. It's going back and forth, isn't it? That's a no answer.
Do you like all of us being here with you?
Going back and forth. Here's a question. Were you murdered?
Nope.
No. That's good to know.
Yeah.
Thank you very
much.
We got several confirmations that something is here at this gateway. Are you picking up anything more?
I'm about 5'4", very skinny, with a kind of a white pillbox, I guess a pillbox hat is what you would call it. He wears white and he's barefooted. His feet are very dirty. He's got long toes. He reminds me of somebody who's just like waiting for their fate. You know, he just kind of stands there with his hands in supplication.
Could he have been a monk?
No. He'd be wearing orange if he was a monk.
Yes.
Yeah, but white is like the death color in the Buddhist community, isn't it?
Yes, I believe that's like our black.
Right. He just kind of sits complacent with his hands in like some kind of...
One of the lotus?
Yeah, but it's like he's waiting. And his hands are in like a position like this. The only thing I can compare that to is like some kind of supplication.
So he's here for some reason. We still don't know why. Thank you very much. But it looks like we definitely have confirmed the Chinese ghost is really here. The old mission, San Buenaventura, has been here since its founding on March the 31st, 1782. This is really ground zero where Ventura began as a community. It was founded by Father Junipero Serra, but much of the work of building this huge artifact belongs to another padre, Jose Señan. He was the man who designed it. And for many years, people have seen a ghostly padre here at this mission. Many believe it might be Jose Señor himself coming back to check on the mission that he founded to make sure it's okay.
Go.
Many believe that it's the Padre himself who haunts here, coming back to see if he can somehow help the parish that he founded. Some say the Padre is not really a frightening ghost at all, but in fact some kind of a unknown saint. He seems dedicated to helping people. In fact, it's rumored that if you come to this old mission and you have a problem, go in and pray, but you must pray for it with a pure heart, and it must be an unselfish prayer. If you do that and see the ghost of the old monk, it means that he will take your message directly to the man upstairs. And the stories abound of people who have seen and encountered this phantom figure. People say that they have many problems.
Go, and if you do that?
They say if you come here and pray with a pure heart, an unselfish prayer, and you see the ghost monk, it means that his spirit will take it on up to the man upstairs. And over again, people have said their prayers have been answered, their problems solved. Right here at the Ventura Mission. Is this area haunted? Now we do know these steps have been used a lot, and people have seen ghosts here. Let's try our ghost hunting team and see if they can get anything at this location. I've asked the EVP group to come to the steps of the mission and see if they can get any evidence that the story of Raimundo Olivas and the Native American uprising of 1824 has any basis in fact. Let's see what they come up with.
We have another real limited area that we're going to be looking at. I want everybody to just do their own specialized little thing. Maria, you see if you get any kind of psychic impressions. Barbara, you can take still pictures if you will. Play with your pendulum, Sarah. And Barbara, you can play with, try to pick up an EVP, look for thermal cold spots. And you have a camera and voice recorder as well, so just more EVPs, okay? And I'll play with the K2 and see if we get some sort of electronic reading. Barbara right in the front here is looking for cold spots, which sometimes indicates the presence of a spirit. If there's a dramatic temperature change for no other explained reason, we can assume that it's possible to be paranormal. Barbara's taking digital pictures. A lot of times we pick up images that we don't necessarily see with our eye, but the camera does pick them up. Howard is taking more pictures, still pictures, and he also has a digital voice recorder, so he's going to be looking for EVPs. And Maria, she looks like she's in a trance, but she's really working. She looks for feelings more than anything. She senses things. She's very intuitive. Sarah has a pendulum.
Oh, we're getting something here. Ask if there's anything here.
Is anything here with us that can move this pendulum?
It's starting to say yes.
Yeah.
Ask, are you a Native American?
Are you a Native American?
Oh, it's going around much faster now.
Yeah. So,
well, that would make sense. The Native Americans built this place.
Did you live here at the mission?
No, didn't live here.
Are you buried here?
Seems like yes.
Yeah, looks like a yes.
That might account for it.
Yeah.
There are many stories linked to ghosts at the Mission Cemetery, which is right next door.
Yeah. Is your family also buried here? Yes.
Oh, yes, it's really moving now.
Yeah.
Was he married? We're assuming it's a he, I suppose.
Well, let's ask. Are you a male? No.
Oh. It's a woman.
So you're a female.
Well, there is a story of a lady in a white dress, believed to be a Native American, who does haunt here, that has been seen numerous times. Maybe it's her.
Have people seen you here at the mission before?
Oh, yes, it's starting to move in a circle.
Yeah.
So the answer is yes.
Did you have any children?
It's moving in a circle.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you very much, Sarah, for helping us out with the pendulum reading. Let's see if we got any readings from anyone else. Did you feel anything here?
Well, the thing, I mean, it's an over, the feeling that I get, especially at the door, is hatred, a real overwhelming sense of hatred and misconstrued promises and stuff. And the thing that's very visual in it all is the blood that's on the stone. I don't know why I keep seeing this, but I keep seeing blood on the stone and the blood soaking into these stones, like these kind of roundish squared stones that they're soaking into. But another thing that keeps coming to me is kings and queens, and I don't know why. But
well, there is a couple of links. We know that the King of Spain gave 6 candlesticks to this mission as a gift.
There is a lot of promises that were broken, and that's the feeling that just keeps working over and over again. I mean, there's no like spirit saying, well, this is what happened or something. It's more of like an overwhelming feel of what has been caught in this area, you know, emotion-wise.
That seems to confirm what we got with the pendulum as well. The accounts we get from the psychic side of things seem to indicate that there definitely is some emotional traces left here at the steps of the old mission. Thank you all for coming and helping us out confirm that there are, in fact, something supernatural going on in downtown Ventura, the mission district. Join us next time as we look for more haunted places on the Ghost Hunters of Ventura County.